So good morning. In last class, we have discussed about the complex power. Okay. So what is the complex power? So in last class, where we have left, we are finding a power, complex power, V I conjugate. Okay. Suppose V is this, and there is a lagging power factor. Okay. Voltage is our reference voltage, and there is suppose lagging power factor. Current is lagging while angle phi. Okay. In that case, I can write I angle. What is the this angle is negative phi. Okay. And I will take its conjugate. Okay. What is this B I angle will become plus phi. Okay. We can write B I cos phi plus j sin phi. So this is the power, complex power. Complex power. So in last class, I have solved one numerical in which I compute P and Q. And there I have written Q equal to B I sine angle minus phi. So this will come minus VI sin phi. But since I am taking conjugate of I, so this angle is positive in case of lagging power factor. So I want to correct there. This is positive, not negative. If you will take its conjugate, then this angle will become positive. Okay, so this is a positive. So in case of lagging power factor, Q is positive. Okay. Similarly, in case of leading power factor, Q will become positive. Sir, is charge nahi ho raha? So now, based on the same concept, I will explain power transmission capability. Okay, what is power transmission capability? Okay. Today, let me look at power transmission capability. Capacity or capability. In your syllabus, it is mentioned power transmission capacity. Okay. So, this is based on the synchronous machine. Okay. So, synchronous machine have a two parts, one in armature and second one is field. Okay. So, in case one, I will consider only armature one. Armature winding. So armature winding have a slot in that we have put conductors. Okay. So conductor size decided by current capability. Okay. Current capacity. It will have certain limit of current. Okay. I maximum. We can't go beyond the maximum value of current for particular size of conductor. So in that case, let me consider a complex power. Okay. This is complex power. Complex power. Here B, I is the armature current. Okay. Since current depend upon the power factor, okay, that's why I will take B as a reference and current, armature current as a lagging. Since most of the loads are lagging in nature, inductive in nature. So I am considering current as a lagging. Okay. If I put, then I am getting S equal to B this. Okay. And we know S equal to P plus JQ. Okay. And this is nothing but BI cos phi plus JBI sin phi. If I will take its magnitude, then this will come under root E square plus U square equal to BI. If I will take BI common, then I am getting under root cos square theta plus sin square theta. Cos square theta sin square theta is 1. This is BI. Okay. So we can say, so this is a BI. Okay. This is magnitude. Okay. So this is actually apparent power. Okay. So from that, we can observe that this is the equation of circle. So I thought you know circle where theta is power factor angle. Okay. I am writing here phi in phi. So you can write here phi. Where phi is power factor angle. So this is nothing but the equation of circle. Okay, what is the equation of circle? E square plus u square equal to vi square. So we know the equation of circle x square plus y square equal to r square. So vi is the radius. So now I am plotting PQ plane in which I will show this circle and radius. So I will show here. This is a P axis. This is a Q axis. Okay. So it's a center is 0, 0. And there is a radius. What? Bi. Bi. Based on that, I have decided this is the point in circle. Okay. Now in next case, we will see another part of synchronous machine. Okay. That is field winding. Case one is armature winding. Now case 2 is field winding. Okay. So let me see field winding. What is the field winding capability? So field winding based on the maximum current. Okay. We have applied DC in field. So there is a IF should be less than from there IF maximum limit. Okay. It should be less than. Okay. So from that, if you are applying field, then there is a induced EMF in the conductor due to this field. Okay. Since field current is proportional to induced voltage. Okay. So if you apply field current, then there is a induced voltage. Okay. Which is in conductor. Okay. So induced voltage depend upon, it will affect insulation. For higher voltage, we have to provide more insulation. So under a steady state condition, the induced EMF limit is less than the E maximum. Okay. So there is a certain limit of insulation level. Okay. So under steady state, we know the power flow or power equation B equal to induced voltage, terminal voltage divided by reactance, okay, of the line into sin delta. This is a power angle or voltage angle. Similarly, we know reactive power. Okay. What is the formula of reactive power? EB divided by X cos delta minus E B square by X. This we have derived, okay, in power equation. So this is a real power, this is reactive power. Okay.
we are considering both power due to this E. Okay? Because due to field, there is an induced EMF, and their induced EMF depend upon the conductor size or insulation provided between the conductors. Okay? So it will have a certain maximum limit of voltage. That's why I have considered both the equation of power flow, real and reactive. Okay? So if I little bit simplify it, simply by adding both equations. Okay? So if I take this in this side, then that is Q plus V square by X. Equal to EV divided by X cos delta. Okay? Suppose this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. If I squaring both equation and adding, then I am getting P square plus U plus V square by X, okay, and whole square equal to EV by X is common in both equation. So I am writing EV by X whole square bracket mein sin square delta plus cos square delta. If I square both equation and adding, then I am getting this result. Okay? So this is what one. This is again P square plus Q plus V square by X whole square equal to EV by X whole square. Okay? So this is again the equation of circuit. Okay? So since this is your origin, so its center is, what is the center of this equation? Center is P0 Q minus V square by X. And what is the radius? EV by X. So this is, suppose this is a Q axis. I am shifting this origin by minus V square by X. So this is a center now. Okay? So if you plot the circle, okay, with radius EV by X, okay, then you are getting something like if you will take radius, then you are getting like that. So this will cut at this point. Okay? And its center is this. Okay? And its radius is what? EV by X. Okay? So this is the radius. Okay? And this is its center. And this point, okay, where two power circles are cutting, is called nameplate rating. Of the machine or maximum rating of transmission capability. Okay. So this is for field current. This is for field current. And first one is for armature current. So these are the two curves from which we have decided the machine rating. Okay? So this is the point where we have decided the machine rating. Okay? So in that way, we have decided the power transmission capability of the given power system. Okay? So this is the derivation for power transmission capability. Okay. In next class,
we will see another topic of this unit. Thank you.